Monday evening, September 27th, 1993. It was a very special night at the state-of-the-art Sony Music Studios in New York City. Some 450 people from the music industry, artists, writers, producers, and executives, as well as colorful Big Apple luminaries, gathered to celebrate the release of the new Neil Diamond album, Up on the Roof, Songs from the Brill Building, and to be treated to a sensational live performance of some of its songs by Neil Diamond himself, backed by Paul Schaefer and the CBS Orchestra. I'm Michael Harrison. Welcome to the Up on the Roof Songs from the Brill Building radio special. During the next hour, we're going to sample some of the music from that album, as well as relive the live performances of that evening, along with exclusive conversations with its participants, Neil Sedaka, Paul Schaefer, Peter Asher, and of course, Neil Diamond. And it's all coming your way in just a moment. Welcome back to the Up on the Roof Songs from the Brill Building radio special as we relive that wonderful night in New York at the Sony Music Studios and Neil Diamond's performance. It was a gala party on the massive soundstage, creatively decorated in a New York City Brill Building motif. We spoke with Neil during rehearsal the night before. Well, here we are at the Sony Music Studios the night before the big party and the big show, and it seems like it's going to be a great show. I was watching Neil Diamond rehearsing, and we have him now for a few minutes between songs and rehearsal. Neil, I guess performing before people in the industry is always very exciting, isn't it?
Well, there'll be a lot of people there who have written these songs, and this album, Up on the Roof, which is our new album, is kind of a tribute to all of these people, so I'll be very excited to see these writers in the audience, and I think it'll give me a little more adrenaline, and it'll be fun.
People who follow pop music, there's something about the Brill Building. It has this great aura of history to it, and you know, when I told people that I was going to be talking to you and that the new album was Up on the Roof, Songs from the Brill Building, people, oh yeah, that was the greatest era of pop music. How do you feel about that era, and what does the Brill Building and all those people mean to you?
Well, I obviously grew up in that era. I wasn't among the people who were writing these great songs at that time, but I was trying, and as a beginner myself. But these people were mostly my age, and they had very high standards of excellence, and I learned a lot through listening to these songs. They were written for the most part by teenagers, and they're pretty sophisticated. But these were the heroes that I aspired to be, and I was knocking around and knocking on doors on the streets while these songs were being written and recorded in the Brill Building.
Ladies and gentlemen, together with Paul Schaefer and his band, please welcome home my friend, Neil Diamond.
One, two!
When this whole world starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face, I climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space. As can be, and there the world below don't bother me. Let me tell you now, when I come home feeling tired and beat, I go up where the air is fresh and sweet. I get away from the hustling crowd and all that rat race noise down in the street. the roofs, the only place I know. Where you just have to wish to make it so. Let's go. Stars put on a show for free. And darling, you can share it all with me. I keep on telling you the great smack dab in the middle of town. I found a paradise that's trouble-proof. And if this world starts getting you down, there's room enough for two up on the roof. Way up on the roof.
All of this music was being written pretty much at the same time in this one building. A lot of it came out from the Burrell building because that's where the writers and the publishers and producers were. And I just wanted to do a tribute, really, to these songs, and they're all great.
Speaking of the songs, and it's quite a list of masterpieces from a pop perspective and a historical perspective, what thought process did you go through in selecting the songs?
Well, we went through, I did this with Peter Asher, who produced the album, went through a lot of songs that were popular from that period and that we thought we knew, and weaned it down to about 50, you know, that we really loved and felt we had to do. And eventually we cut that down to what it presently is, which is 16 of the creme de la creme, I think. These are songs that I felt I could add something to as a singer and not just, you know, a copy or record. So, well, we picked out these 15 or 16 songs, and this is our best shot.
When you were a little girl, you had a rag doll, the only doll you've ever owned. I love you just the way you love that rag doll, but only now my love has grown. You need to get stronger in every way. You need to get stronger, baby. Let me say, you need to get higher day by day. Young girl, did you have a puppy that always followed you around? Well, I've loved you faithful as that puppy. You know I'll never let you down. 'Cause it gets stronger like the river flows. And it gets bigger, baby. Then it gets sweeter, baby, as it grows. Do I love you? flower loves the spring. And I love you, baby, like the robin loves to sing. I love you, baby, like a schoolboy loves his pie. I love you, baby, with a deep mountain high. Ow!
Neil Diamond, backed by Paul Schaefer and the CBS Orchestra, performing River Deep Mountain High at the party celebrating the release of the album. As Neil said, the legendary Peter Asher served as producer of the album Up on the Roof, Songs from the Brill Building.
How do you feel about this record that is being celebrated tonight and its world release? Certainly a very special record.
Well, it was particularly fun to do because, I mean, Neil's a great pleasure to work with anyway. He's funny and he's a great singer and he's a pleasure to work with in general. In particular, this record, of course, once the concept was established, the body of songs to choose from was so huge and so tremendous that the hardest part, Neil and I found, was picking the songs to do because there were so many great songs from that era. So Neil and I would sit together with his guitar or sometimes with his band and just try stuff out and see what was going to work. And that really made it fun, because usually on a record, you're an ordinary album, you're hustling to find 10 great songs to do. In this case, once the phrase Brill Building had been uttered, suddenly there were 50 great songs to choose from. And that was unusual and difficult, but really fun.
Amazing how many songs came out of that era.
Exactly so.
You think of a few.
Such brilliant writers.
The production on those records back in the 60s, all through the 60s, it was a certain era in production. And when you hear them, you just know it. Now producing in the 90s, doing songs from that period, did you try to create that sound at all?
No. I think Neil and I both agreed it would be a mistake to try to recreate the old records or even the old sounds, but simply to approach them as songs and to work out the best kind of arrangement, the best kind of sound for Neil for that song. So while it's neither a self-consciously modern sound nor a self-conscious recreation of a past sound, it's simply taking the song as an entity on its own and figuring out the best way for Neil to do it.
Oh, yes. Took my troubles down to Madame Ruth. You know that gypsy with the gold cap tooth. She's got a pad down in 34th and Vine, selling little bottles of love potion number 9. I told her that I was a flop with chicks. Way since 1956, she looked at my palm and she made a magic sign. She said, "What you need is love potion number 9." She bent down and turned around and gave me a wink. She said, "I'm gonna mix it up right here in the sink. It smelled like turpentine, it looked like India ink." My nose, I closed my eyes, took a drink. I didn't know if it was day or night. I started kissing everything in sight. But when I kissed a cop down a 34th and Vine, he broke my little bottle of love potion number 9. We'll be right back.
gonna mix it up right here in the sink. It smelled like turpentine and looked like India ink. I held my nose, I closed my eyes, took a drink. I didn't know if it was day or night. I started kissing everything in sight. But when I kissed that cop down on 34th and Vine, he broke my little bottle of love potion number 9. Love potion number 9. Love potion number 9. Love potion number 9.
One of the most colorful and certainly historically pertinent members of the audience that evening was Neil Sedaka.
Well, I was one of the first at the Brill Building, yes, and I was 13 years old when I started writing songs in New York.
You're kidding.
And wrote for Ahmet Erdogan and Jerry Wexler, Atlantic Records, and then part of that whole New York scene.
Can you remember that first year, what it was like to get involved in writing songs with those heavyweights of the record business?
Well, Howie Greenfield and I were the first to go to Alden Music in 1650 Broadway, and then we met Connie Francis and Bobby Darin, and we had a very exciting time at the beginning of rock and roll. We wrote Stupid Cupid and Where the Boys Are, and then Neil Diamond came, and he's sensational, and I'm so happy for his success.
Did those songs come easy? Did they just flow out of you, or did you go through, you know, the struggle and the pain of writing?
Well, I was a concert pianist, and I had a very extensive musical background, so it was a little easier for me than a four-chord guitar player. Mm-hmm.
So actually, this music was simpler than what you had already been trained to do.
At the start, it was, yes, the beginning. Mm-hmm.
So it's got to be very exciting for you tonight to see the music of that era being honored, and your friend Neil Diamond being honored, and a record coming out with an artist of the stature of Neil Diamond celebrating the Brill Building era. How does it feel?
Very exciting. Those songs are timeless. I think it's a good move. It's a marvelous collection and good era. And we are from the same neck of the woods in Brighton Beach, Brooklyn. And we went to the same high school, Lincoln High School. And
isn't that amazing how that happens? How kids from the same area will spark a whole movement within an art scene.
It was a phenomenon. I think it was a very ethnic kind of feeling. It was a musical feeling. Myself, Carole King, Neil Diamond, Paul Simon, Doc Pomus, Jeff Barry, it was kind of a close-knit group in Brooklyn.
This event is certainly made more special by your presence. And
thank you. And Neil asked me to sing a duet with him, so I'm delighted.
And we will be hearing that very likely on the radio tonight.
Great.
Tonight, is it true that Neil Sedaka is actually here in the building? Or is that some rumor that I heard? Neil, are you here? Come over here, Neil Sedaka. Everybody say hi to my hero. My Brooklyn buddy. Wow.
Are we gonna sing?
Let's do one of yours because...
Two guys named Neil.
Okay.
All right. Never rehearsed this, believe it or not.
But we still have to get it perfect.
I know, I remember the words.
One, two, three, four, I go. Because you're not a baby
for those harmonies
anymore. You've turned into the prettiest girl I've ever seen. Yeah. Happy birthday, sweet 16.
We're doing good so far, huh?
Sounds good.
What happened to that funny face? My little tomboy now wears satins and lace.
Here's the words, here's the words.
I can't believe my eyes. You're just a teenage dream, yeah.
All together.
Happy birthday, sweet 16.
Let's get to the bridge. We do it together?
Yeah, do the first part.
When you were only six,
hey, hey,
you had a big brother.
Yes, I did.
And then when you were 10, you didn't like each other.
Here we go.
When you were 13, you were my funny Valentine.
But since you've grown up, your future is sewn up. From now on, you're gonna be fine. So if I should smile,
yes, sir,
with sweet surprise, it's just that you've grown up before my very eyes. You've turned into the prettiest girl I've ever seen.
Big finish, big finish.
Happy birthday, sweet 16.
You ready?
Oh, yes.
If I should smile.
Take it, Neil. I haven't heard you do it for a while.
With sweet surprise.
Love that voice.
It's just that you've grown up before my very eyes. You've turned into the prettiest girl I've ever seen. Happy birthday, sweet 16.
Do it with me.
Cha la 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 la. Happy birthday, sweet 16.
One more time.
Cha la 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 la. Happy birthday, sweet 16.
One more time.
Cha la 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 la. Happy birthday, sweet 16.
Oh yeah.
Say
it, Mr. Neil Sedaka.
Neil Diamond, Neil Sedaka, Paul Schaefer, and the CBS Orchestra absolutely delighting the audience. You're listening to the Up on the Roof Songs from the Brill Building Radio Special, featuring live performances by Neil Diamond, backed by Paul Schaefer and the CBS Orchestra at the Sony Music Studios in New York City, as well as songs from the album itself. We'll hear more music and conversations with Neil Diamond and Paul Schaefer when we continue in just a moment.
You know when your throat's so dry and scratchy, it feels like you swallowed some sand? You need medicine, not those candy cough drops. You need Cepacol lozenges. But what if your throat feels like you swallowed all the sand on Malibu Beach? Not to mention 5 beach chairs, 3 volleyball nets, and a surfer named Chuck.
No, dude.
Then you need really strong medicine. You need Cepastat lozenges. Cepacol for sore throats. Cepastat for really sore throats. Use only as directed.
What do you do every morning?
Jog.
How do you spell jog?
J-O-G.
You know what that means in Spanish, French, German, Italian, or Japanese?
J-O-G?
It means you can get a free audio cassette player with headphones when you order National Dynamic Speed Tapes.
So I can learn any foreign language while I'm working out?
Any foreign language.
And it comes with a free cassette player?
Call 1-800-545-1985.
Order any foreign language from National Dynamics and get a free cassette player.
1-800-545-1985.
When I was a kid, Mom was always after me to eat right.
Well, that's what mothers do.
Now I'm looking out for her with Ensure. More than a vitamin supplement, Ensure is a delicious drink with all the nutrients adults need to stay healthy, active, be energetic.
You know, dear, Ensure is even recommended number one by doctors as a source of complete, balanced nutrition.
Drink Ensure as a meal or in between. To your health, Mom.
Our health, dear.
Use as directed.
Hooked on Phonics. To give your preschooler a head start in reading, press A. For help with reading comprehension, press B. For older students who have fallen behind in reading, C. To improve spelling skills, D. For adults ready to teach themselves to read, press E. For all your reading needs, call 1-800-ABCDEFG and put Hooked on Phonics under your Christmas tree.